Hi. Today, we're going to make a simple recipe for spaghetti bolognese, but along the way, you're also going to learn a few cooking tricks that will help you with plenty other recipes and even a little bit of history. Bolognese sauce gets its name from the city of Bologna, the capital city of the Emilia-Romagna region of northern Italy. If you're thinking of Italy as a boot, then this would be the area just below the flared cuff. In Italy, bolognese sauce is traditionally served with tagliatelle, which is a flat, ribbon-like noodle, or it is used as a meat filling in a lasagna. For this recipe, we're going to make the Americanized version, spaghetti bolognese, but you can actually use just about any noodle type you want when you make it. Okay, let's talk prep. It's best to have all of your ingredients out and ready to go, just so that you're sure you aren't missing something after you've already started cooking. For this recipe, you're going to need the following. 4 quarts of water, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 tablespoon olive oil, 1 pound of lean ground beef, about 80% lean, 1 half an onion, diced, 1 medium carrot, shredded, 1 stalk of celery, shredded, 4 garlic cloves, minced, 1 14-ounce can of crushed tomatoes, 1 24-ounce jar of marinara sauce, 2 teaspoons of dried basil, 1 teaspoon each of dried oregano and dried parsley, 1/2 a teaspoon of dried thyme, 1 box dry pasta of your choosing. Now that we've got our ingredients, let's start our water boiling. Start off with hot water from the faucet. There's an old wives' tale that cold water will come to a boil faster than room temperature water, but this is completely untrue. Turn that faucet to hot and wait for the cold water to clear the pipes. Then fill your pot with the recommended amount of water. For most pastas, this will be 4 quarts, but you should double check the box. Add a teaspoon of salt. Set the water to high heat and put the lid on. You'll also want to start the pan for the sauce heating. Set the heat to medium-low, just slightly less than the middle point, and drizzle on that tablespoon of olive oil. Some people worry about the fat content in olive oil and avoid it, but the majority of the fatty acids in olive oil is oleic acid, which actually has plenty of health benefits. We're also going to drain off the excess grease when we're done cooking the meat. While that's heating up, let's make sure our cutting board is stable. Many of them come with some form of rubber foot on the bottom, but a lot of them are just smooth plastic on both sides. If your cutting board slides around on the countertop, you can place a moist paper towel under it to create traction. Next up, knife usage. Most people make the mistake of trying to cut by just pressing down with the blade. This makes it hard to control the cut. You actually want to cut in a wave motion, pressing down only slightly as the blade slides forward or backwards. This way, the entire length of the blade does the cutting and not just one small part of it. Our recipe calls for shredded carrots and celery, but those are optional. I recommend them just because it gives the sauce more body and flavor, and it makes it a healthier dish. The easiest way to shred them is to use a grater, sometimes known as a cheese grater. You'll want to use the finest, meaning the smallest option, because this will make the veggies cook faster. Next, some diced onion.